الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله نبينا محمد وآله وصحبه أجمعين. There is a authentic hadith that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, من صلى في اليوم والليلة 12 ركعة سوى المكتوبة بني له بيت في الجنة. Whoever pray 12 ركعة day and night other than the mandatory, a house is built for him in the paradise. 12 rak'ah, other than the 5 prayers. Whoever pray, a house is built for him in the Jannah. These 12 rak'ah are 2 rak'ah before Fajr, 4 rak'ah before Dhuhr, 2 rak'ah after Asr. Yes. How many rak'ah before Dhuhr? 4. How many rak'ah after Dhuhr? 2. How many together those? 8. Okay, sorry to confuse you. I'll repeat. 2 rak'ah before Fajr. And 4 rak'ah before Dhuhr. 2 rak'ah after Dhuhr. Those are 8. Okay, very good. And 2 rak'ah after Maghrib. And 2 rak'ah after Isha. 12. They are those, they are next, they are that important. Whoever prays, Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala build a house for him in the Jannah. The best place to perform those salawat is in the house. Rather, the salah, the sunnah you pray in the house is better than the one you pray in the masjid 27 times. They're sound hadith. The sunnah prayers. The sunnah prayers you pray at the house is better than the one you pray in the masjid 27 times. But yes, you can pray in the masjid. Just like female, it's better for them to pray all the salawat in their houses. But they can still pray in the masjid. So if there is, especially if there is a reason, someone who is going now, right after Isha, is going to work, is not going back to house before the Isha time ends. When Isha time ends, middle of the night. So those 2 rak'ah, which follows the Isha, should be within the time of Isha. Then after, otherwise it's not following the Isha, unless the person forget or he make it up. So someone may not go back to home before middle of the night, so he prays these 2 rak'ah in the masjid. Or someone who is not that strong to pray at house, he's busy in the house, then he prays in the masjid before he leave. So he can pray these 12 rak'at and he get this bigger, great reward of having house in the Jannah. The people of knowledge mention one of the benefits of these 12 rak'at is protection for the mandatory. Do you think the person who prayed 2 rak'at before Fajr is leaving the Fajr itself? The answer is no. The one who prayed 4 rak'at before Dhuhr is leaving the Dhuhr itself? No. Now, therefore, those who don't pray those sunnah, they're struggling with the mandatories. Either catching up late or they're struggling. But if the person makes his goal the sunnah, most likely, inshallah, he will perform the mandatory. And that itself is a great benefit, not to compromise with the mandatories. Plus, this rak'at sunnah, it complete the mandatory. It complete the mandatory. We don't perform the mandatories as we should, of having khushu, of fulfilling the rites of the prayer. There may be weakness. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala complete that weakness in the mandatories from the sunnah. If we don't have sunnah, then where it will be completed? So inshallah ta'ala, to remember those 12 rak'ah, we ask Allah al-Karim to help us with it. Allahu a'lam wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad.